So now that I'm home, guys, what I wanted to talk about tonight was key terms that you need to know if you were to invest in a mobile home park. As you do know, I do.
Good morning, guys. Welcome back to the vlog. Summer morning off today. Just had to make my lunch for the day because I forgot to do it last night. Got a business meeting in 5 minutes. So I got to start the morning off.
Some nice coffee as usual. I broke my
the glass coffee pot thing. So I had to like break off the little stem thing in there so I can just put a cup there.
But it works. So I got this for about 40 minutes and I'm gonna shower and we'll get to the office. So Southwoods, we got the financials on it. Jim had a couple questions on their P&L. I sent an email to the lawyer to try.
She said I hate my day job. I don't feel it. I need race car. Top down to match my ceiling. I don't have none. She said I hate my day job. I don't feel it. I need race car. Top down to match my ceiling. I don't have none.
Hey Jeff, my name's Armand Violi.
You've reached Lewis Quality Home.
Your call has been forwarded.
You have reached the office of Sweet Ray.
2 hours later.
So what that is, I've been working on this morning, are rent comps for three potential listings that we're gonna get. So when we wanna present our underwriting to a potential owner and potentially get it as a listing, we need to call around and get an idea of what the other parks in the area are charging. So that way we could accurately show if like there's room to raise rents and increase the value of the property, or maybe it's top of the market, or is there strong demand in the area if the other parks are charging the same price, but there's more vacancies. So we need to figure those things out. Typically try and call 5 properties in the immediate area of whatever listing that we're working on. In that sense, I got 3 parks done. One of the problems was one of the parks is in the middle of Michigan in middle of nowhere. So it was hard to find that. Right now it's lunchtime, so I'm gonna go eat and then I'll see you guys when I'm back.
She said I hate my day job. I don't feel it. I need race car. Top down.
Okay guys, so it's 6:15 right now. I'm heading home from the office. Gotta go grab my gear because I'm heading to Fusion XL tonight for some mixed martial arts training. Probably gonna do some gi jiu-jitsu. Might do kickboxing after, but I know I gotta get home and then I have something I wanna record for this episode after. A fun fact you might not know, this place, Fusion XL, this is the gym that Mike Perry is technically still a part of. That's where all like the drama in the UFC and everything, everyone's heard about him getting in trouble in the media. Yeah, this is the gym that he trained at and rose up in, which is cool. There's tons of high-level guys here like Jacare, Rodolfo Vieira. But anyways, I'll see you guys when I get there.
Pull the trigger, ain't nobody gonna do for you. Pull the trigger.
Maybe you should pull the fucking trigger.
Alright, so I'm here at Fusion XL doing a little bit of jiu-jitsu. Look who decided to show up.
The man, the myth, the legend with the blue. With the blue, baby.
Laborio blue belt.
Oh yeah,
know?
Man. But we're just gonna get some jiu-jitsu in. Fuck kickboxing. A little bit of gi. Honestly, I hope they don't put me through the ringer again because last time I got my ass beat. Like, I don't know what it is, but after working in an office for 9 hours, I still don't feel like training. Like, I just feel exhausted just mentally and shit. But I guess let's go kick some ass.
You should pull the fucking trigger.
Pull the trigger. Ain't nobody gonna do for you. Pull the trigger. Don't hesitate, just shoot.
Yeah, why you believe in the propaganda? Why everybody sound like they wanna be from Atlanta? Are you the voice of the echo? Are you the nail of the hammer? I be talking while chewing my beats. I don't mind my manners. Courses that fit the opera. That's why I need phantoms. I got my doubt at gunpoint. That's why I need ransoms and not be handsome. That's why I got your girl before the money. Honestly, I thought I'd have 30 M's before my 20s. But I'm cool with how it's happening. Girl in San Fran who wants to cross routes with me. Like a young Colin Kaepernick. Treat the money like a ladder or I'm passing it. Cause my family's number one. Never put them number two. Trying to buy a house in cash for all the times we had to move. All the times my mom cried cause she ain't know what else to do. All the times she lost hope cause she ain't know what else to lose. All the times I shoot shots cause I don't know what else to shoot.
3, 2, 1, Because I'm back up on my business. Me and money got a fresh account.
me. Fucking exhausted. I didn't want to do that last round.
What'd you do, bro? You feeling
good? I got fucked up, dude.
Yeah.
For some tough motherfuckers here, dude.
Later, bro. See you guys. Later, dog. Later, bro.
So now that I'm home, guys, what I wanted to talk about tonight was key terms that you need to know if you were to invest in a mobile home park. As you do know, I do broker mobile home park deals, aka manufactured housing communities. It was the strongest performing asset class throughout COVID-19, so it's pretty hot. It's been pretty hot for the last few years. It's similar to apartments, but there are its own intricacies that you actually need to know about. So common terms that you need to know. Well, let's say you have a 100 unit park, just to keep it simple. You need to know of the 100 units, of the 100 pads, is it lot rents or is it park-owned homes? Lot rents are pretty much you own the lot and the infrastructure, and someone who owns the home rents out that lot from you and they park their own home on it, and you don't have to manage their home, which is preferable. And then on the flip side, you have park-owned homes, which means you own the home, which typically gets you a higher return with cash flow, but it also comes with more management costs, it's harder to get financing, etc. Lot rents, park-owned homes.
What are you doing, Fonzo?
Next, I need to know what your utilities are. Let's start with water. Water, there's honestly two things that you could have: city water or well water. City water is preferable. The reason why city water is preferable is the city is responsible for the underground lines, the city responsible for providing the water. It's way simpler, easier to manage. Well, you have to maintain, you own the well. If anything goes wrong, you have to dish out the money for it. So those are the two things you need to know. Next, there's sewers. There's four types of sewers. City, which is what you preferably want. And then after that, you got a wastewater treatment plant. You also have septic tanks, and you also have a lagoon. Now, one rare one that is super rare is a spray field, where the sewage actually gets treated and sprayed onto grass. That's like a super rare thing. And me personally, I've only came across a handful of them. Obviously, city sewer would be more preferable just for ease of management. Then septic people prefer over wastewater treatment plant, but I know some people that prefer wastewater treatment plant over septic. They all come with their own specific maintenance costs, so you just have to be familiar with them. Next would be your trash. Some people do trash dumpsters, some people do curbside pickup. You just gotta figure out what your management costs with that. After that, next thing you need to know, you need to figure out how a property manager is paid, how much that costs. You need to figure out repairs and maintenance on the common areas of the park. If there's park-owned homes, you need to know repairs and maintenance for that. Then you need to know how much is a maintenance guy paid. Assuming it's a larger park, they probably have a manager and a maintenance guy full-time. Smaller parks, obviously, they might just hire out as needed and just have a manager. And next, there's also a thing called a management fee. So a lot of syndicators, they take a particular fee for running the whole property for their investors. So aside from management costs, maintenance costs, repairs and maintenance, you're gonna run into certain investors who actually take a management fee from the actual cash flow. So that's another thing to consider. After that, you're gonna wanna assume some form of accounting fees, legal fees. These aren't huge costs, but it's something that you actually need to consider. You also need to find out, how does a park do either telephones, Wi-Fi, and all of that? Some people provide it, some people don't, which ties me back to also the water, sewer, and trash. Some people bill back to the residents, depending on what type of water system, sewer system, and how they do the trash. Like a lot of times there'll be city water and it's billed to the park, but then the park bills it back to the tenants. Sometimes the tenants have their own account with the city and pay for their water and electric that way. There's a lot of different ways. You just have to figure out when you're actually going into a park, and you need to understand how all those expenses are actually billed. Aside from that, you have miscellaneous expenses, road maintenance, lawn caring, plowing if it's in an area that snows. But yeah, that pretty much covers your basics of what you need to know when you're analyzing a mobile home park. Anyways, I hope that anyone who is interested in this particular asset class when it comes to investing in real estate find this video helpful. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I do this all for free, and I'd appreciate you guys' support. Thanks for watching again, and have a good night.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars.